Hi, welcome back to Blended Learning Tips for Teachers. Today's tip is to use progress monitors and to set individual goals for students when working in student applications. So in my classroom, students use Rosetta Stone, System 44, and Read 180 when working independently at their computers during our station rotations. I noticed that my students were not making as much progress in the applications as I was hoping they were. I could see in class that they were on track, but when I went and logged in on the teacher side, they just weren't moving up through their topics and their lessons. This got even worse when the EL coordinator came to me and said that my students were pretty much stagnant in Rosetta Stone after 2 months of school. I knew I had to do something. I'd been using stickers to help them keep track of their lessons, like, see this? My System 44 comes with this little chart, and I had the kids putting stickers on it. And in Rosetta Stone, I was using a similar one. And putting the stickers on was kind of motivating them, but it wasn't enough. So instead, in small groups, I actually intervened, and I took 1 week where every time the kids came to me, I said, okay, where are you right now? Everyone needs to move up. It was like 8 circles before October. And then after October, okay, everyone needs to move up 6 more before December. I made their goals relevant to how many days of class we had available for station rotation time. Once I started doing that, my kids started working a lot more, and they've been, since then, they've been more on task in their rotations. And so I just put the little stickers here, and when they sit with me, the process of putting the stickers on the books during small group with me actually makes them a little bit more accountable, because when they're talking to me face to face, I can be like, okay, look, you're not progressing. It's because when I look over, you're kind of zoning out and looking at the wall, or you're not really moving. Could you be listening to YouTube maybe instead of doing your work? And we're having those conversations, which really help things to go along. When I don't have the sticker charts, I also have just been printing their data off of the application, and then I just draw a line for wherever their goal is, and I put like October, this is where you need to be, and then I can print these every couple of weeks. I know other teachers go ahead and make the progress charts themselves on the computer. The trick is just to make the progress chart, and then when kids are in the teacher station for the small group instruction, take a little bit of time to have each kid update their progress and have the meaningful conversations to help motivate them. This is better than any sort of little carrots or sticks or tying it to a grade or anything. It's been the best thing I've found so far to keep them slowly working at their stations, because it's really hard to keep everyone focused when they're all at different points. So again, my tip is, when you have students working independently on the computer, make sure that you have set up some sort of a system with a tracker progress monitoring chart, and give each kid an individual goal, and then celebrate their accomplishments in class. By the way, those goals can also be tied to something more concrete like grades if you need to. It's more effective than time on task, which is what some teachers do. I hope this has been helpful. If you have any other tips to keep kids on track when they are in their stations, please let me know. And of course, I'll be sharing more too. I'm just sharing one a day now. So thank you very much. If you like this, give it a thumbs up, and subscribe for more tips. Bye.